What's up, everyone? Right now, Heather's checking out Bram's tooth. Because his tooth is so loose, like, he can't even bite into anything because it's, like, it needs to come out already, you know? But he's so scared that he hasn't been moving it or touching it or doing anything. So, I mean, we're going to have to take it out. It sucks. But it's gotten to the point where the other tooth is actually kind of below it. So when he bites into things, it hurts him. Undo the intro. I was just telling Bram how Squidward laughs. I was like, yeah.
Yes, he does.
And Bram was like, Squidward doesn't laugh. I was like, yeah, he does. I seen him laugh in the last episode. You want to show everyone your teeth that you got out, buddy? Yeah. See, it wasn't that bad, huh? He's still all, because he's all tired and burnt out. And Bram didn't get much sleep last night. So... other than that, we're just hanging out, guys. Might hit Manny's later. Trying to see if he's online. Might be, might not. Who knows? I like how when Facebook notifies you, it tells me that Jason has posted on my timeline. That's so stupid. Jason's posted on my timeline, and I keep clicking it to open it, and it won't open it. Facebook. Lame. Sitting here watching some zombies, or how we would make zombies, and in the and before the show starts and goes again, what's it have? It has like the zombie handbook or something.
How to fight a zombie.
How to fight a zombie, and they're giving you all these weapons and choices to kill zombies. It's pretty awesome. Next time one comes up, I'll try to record it. It'd be pretty rad. We'll see.
That was a lame one. That wasn't a cool one.
That was actually a pretty stupid one. Wasn't even the normal guy who was doing it. He's like, hey, check up Rose on me. We're gonna check up the lights. Really? Like, no, dude, no. Wait till you guys see another one. It'll be awesome. Awesome. 50s and early 60s. The magazines hold 30 rounds. There's an abundance of different types of ammo available.
Disadvantages, it's going to be a little bit harder to conceal, and ammo for this gun might be a little bit hard to come by. For up close, zombie threats, handguns are a great choice. Like this 22 target pistol right here. Advantages to this, the rounds are very small, they're available at hardware stores, and you can carry a lot on your person. Disadvantages, you're only going to get about 25 to 50 meters of good distance out of this weapon, and it's not going to punch through any type of barrier very well. Shot placement is critical. If you look right here, my entrance wound where I put it was somewhere right above the bridge of the nose. We follow it to the back and we see the exit wound, and the exit wound's not near as dramatic, but it still got the job done. And another popular handgun is a 9mm handgun. 9mm kind of bridges the gap between 22 and say a 12 gauge. It gives you excellent barrier penetration. They're accurate and they're effective out to about 50 meters. Disadvantages, 9mm again might be hard to find unless you're near a military or law enforcement area. This is a pump action shotgun like this Remington 870. They've been around for over 100 years. They fire a 12 gauge round and are devastating up close in both terminal ballistics and barrier penetration. Side back here, if we look, it is total destruction. Pons medulla is completely gone. The zombie spine cut in half. This is probably one of the premier zombie hunting guns right here.
Whatever weapon you choose, there's a lot more to consider than simply firepower when it comes to battling zombies.
And so these zombies are pretty... these zombie attack people are pretty crazy on this. They're pretty... like, we're gonna turn into zombies for the world just ending. So, anyways, guys, check this out. Here's actual 100% laws. Actual laws and states. Let me read some to you. Having sexual relations with a porcupine in Florida is illegal. Okay? So no having sex with porcupines. All right, here's another one. In Alabama, men who deflower virgins, regardless of their age or marital status, may face up to 5 years in jail. That's pretty gnarly. In Iowa, one-armed piano players must perform for free. Hell's up with that? They should get more money, right? Got one arm? All right, I'll do one more for you guys. Let me find one. Okay, right here. It is illegal for a woman to stand within 5 feet of a bar while drinking in Wyoming. So women in Wyoming, don't stand 5 feet to a bar or you will go to jail. Just letting you know. I'll let that slide today, and I'll tell you guys more tomorrow if you guys are interested in hearing about the stupid laws.